Anyway, let's discuss this all as a group one more time. We still have time to make our decision.
That's very true.
Our lives are all on the line.
Excellent. Then shall we resume our game of hide and seek?
But if Yaku didn't do it, then who's the real killer? Who murdered Chihiro? One thing we can be sure that we know about the killer was able to gain access to the real murder scene, which means it was a guy. Since the crime scene was the boys' locker room, you need to be needed a boys' handbook to get in. Since Leon's handbook is apparently broken, the killer would have had to use their own. In other words, it would have to be a guy. But that's still not enough. I need to find some more clues. And hopefully we'll find more clues here. Celeste account. To work out. Who would she ask to work out with? Is that what you're trying to get at?
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, clues are one thing, but did nobody get a look at the killer?
I'm sure if someone saw the killer, they would have said something by now.
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some point. Even that would be enough for now.
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new info.
It's over.
Shit.
It's all over. You want to know who saw the victim? The killer. And only the
no,
killer.
Wait, hold on. This one's right. I'm glad I missed.
No, it's wrong.
I'm glad I missed. It worked out in the end.
I believe someone else did see the victim before he was murdered. What do you think, Celeste?
Now that you mention it, yes. I did see him.
Huh? Really?
Oh, but I suppose only Makoto knows about this.
Yeah, why would you only tell me? Why would you only tell me?
The rest of you had no idea, did you? That is why you're all making such ugly noises.
Whatever! Just hurry up and tell us!
It was last night, right before nighttime. I saw Chihiro in the dormitory warehouse. I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag, and then, I assume, he headed off to exercise.
A track jacket and a duffel bag? But we didn't find anything like that at the murder scene.
It seems likely that the culprit destroyed them to get rid of any evidence.
And that is when he said something that struck me as rather odd.
I better get going, I'm kind of in a hurry.
Chihiro told me he was in a hurry. But why would he be in a hurry? Only if someone were waiting for him, I should think.
So, Mr. Fujisaki was on his way to meet with someone, and then they were going to work out together?
But Hina and I had invited him to exercise with us plenty of times, and he always declined.
Because he wouldn't be able to, you guys would be in different locker rooms.
Probably because he was afraid you'd find out the secret he was hiding, right?
Yeah.
Which means that conversely, he must have trusted whoever he was meeting with very much. Enough so that he was willing to risk his secret being revealed.
That was probably his secret.
Friendship. The point is, whoever he met up with is the culprit, right? So we just gotta figure out who it was.
But knowing what we know, I can't even guess.
No. You already have what you need to make the connection.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yep.
You know who the killer is.
Do I?
Seriously?
I know, but does Nagi know?
Who is it? Who's the killer?
Think back to the track jacket and duffel bag the killer disposed of. Focus on the details of these items, and it should become obvious who was waiting for him.
Are you sure about that? You really think we can figure out who did it based on two pieces of evidence that we don't have?
Who would it be?
What? You want to track down some fingerprints or something?
I don't know what she's getting at. I don't know what she's getting at
Even
at all.
Even if we had the equipment for that, we wouldn't know how to use
it. Yeah, wait, what?
As was noted, the evidence is already gone. There's nothing to get fingerprints from.
Maybe, but we can make certain inferences if we just take the time to talk it out.
Easy for you to say, but fine. Celeste, did you notice anything special about the bag or jacket?
The bag was just a normal duffel bag from the warehouse.
All the bags in there are the same, so I can't imagine what would make that one special.
Well, if I remember right, there was a decent variety of tracksuits to choose from.
It's blue tracksuit.
Do you think there might be some connection between the culprit and Chihiro's jacket?
Perhaps. Let's explore that and talk a bit more about the jacket he took.
Chihiro's jacket really hold some clue about the killer? Yeah, it's kind of hard to believe. I don't know. What about Celestic count again? That's not gonna fly. We're not using that one again.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise. So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
Yeah, I don't get it. What? Blue? No, the blue.
I got it. He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing.
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black.
Hold on.
I have a tracksuit. Because exercising sucks.
I have a white tracksuit, personally. I got it from the warehouse, if you must know.
How do you know it's blue?
Did any of that really help us get any closer to figuring out?
No. Maybe it is the less account. Hold on.
First of all,
did he just drop the ball?
Why did he choose?
What do you mean?
I got it! It matched the one.
So,
the killer was wearing the same blue.
No, that's wrong!
Mondo. How do you know it was a blue tracksuit? We never said anything about the color of it.
Hold on a second, Mondo. What did you just
say?
Yeah,
Mondo.
Huh? What'd I say?
When Celeste testified a few minutes ago, she said...
She just said nothing about the color. She just said duffel bag. And then after exercise, she said nothing about
she
the fucking color of the jacket.
The jacket's color.
How do you know?
So why did you say Chihiro's blue tracksuit?
Oh, fuck.
What are you? You just...
He dropped it. He's gone. He's dead.
Hey,
he did it. He's
what
dead.
What color was Chihiro's tracksuit?
Yeah, what was it?
As a matter of fact, it was blue.
And there it is. Solved another crime. Not solved another
thing. Did you tell anyone that?
He just told me
the
that.
The only one
yep.
I told about any of this was you.
And there it is.
Mondo, how did
He's
you
dead.
Know what color
he did it.
Chihiro's tracksuit was?
But because I just...
You lost, man. Take
so
the L. Nope,
the
you're done. You're done. You can't. Ishimaru, I'm sorry, but your bro's dead.
No, that can't be it.
You've been bros for a day, and he's nearly gone.
The clothes were surely disposed of by the time we began our investigation.
Then the only reason he could have known what color the tracksuit was...
If
he saw Cherry with it before he died!
Cherry?
That's the only possibility!
Cherry? Oh, that's a good nickname for Cherry. Cherry. First Big Mac and now Cherry? I like the nicknames.
So, how about it? Did you see the tracksuit or didn't you?
Just by chance. I just happened to see it last night.
Aw, man, Mondo, I'm sorry.
He walked past me, and he was carrying the tracksuit in his hands.
I'm sorry, Mondo, you're done.
That can't be it either. According to Celeste's testimony,
stuffed the bag under bag, stuffed her jacket in the bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it, so that she was gone. She hid it. She put it back in her bag.
Chihiro made a point of making sure the jacket was completely in the bag.
Mondo, you're
just ran into him briefly.
You're fucked, Mondo.
Possibly have seen what color the tracksuit was.
It was all good up until that point. It was all good up until that point, man. I'm sorry.
You've dug your own grave.
I'm sorry, Mondo. You're dead. You're dead.
You handed him the shovel, didn't you? That's why you said what you did.
Absolutely.
Focus
yes.
On the tracksuit and it'll be obvious who he met with? What a bunch of nonsense.
Kyogo is amazing.
Now
once
I
more.
Understand. It was all one big
it
bluff,
was a bluff.
Your true intention was to draw a slip of the tongue from the culprit. That's why
Kyogo's amazing.
Who did it, to put them on edge.
That's right. However, Mondo was my target all along. I had my suspicions about him from the very beginning.
But why?
Yeah, why?
What made you so suspicious?
Because he's the strongest man out of all of us.
That's a good question.
The way he talked.
There was a certain turn.
What was that?
That tipped me off.
What was that, like, click there?
Maybe you didn't notice it, Mondo, but you tend to refer to men and women differently. You only
what
call
that, like,
guys dude. For
yeah.
Girls, it's chick.
That's true. Yep. And then he stopped.
And after he was killed, you happened to refer to him as dude.
Yeah.
Once I picked up on that, it occurred to me that Mondo knew something we didn't.
You didn't notice such a tiny detail?
Are you a witch? She's a witch! You're positive.
I mean, I said it. I said it too,
no,
guys. Come on.
I'm not the frightful one. Not nearly as frightful as someone capable of murdering a friend.
Oof. Oof. Burned. Oh, fuck, Mondo. You're done.
Mondo, was it really you? Did you really kill Chihiro?
I didn't kill anyone! You've been all over me, judging everything I say, putting words in my mouth.
Sorry, Mondo.
What gives you the right to treat me like a goddamn criminal?
Yeah, he would never do something like that. This is a false accusation.
It's true. My reasoning on that is pretty shaky.
That was fast.
Well, this does present us with a problem. It seems we are all out of leads.
Yeah, you had a fucking clue too. You didn't tell us anything about it. What was it?
That's what my little ghost friend is telling me.
Fucking tell us.
Oh yeah, that reminds.
Yeah,
me.
You what?
Yifune, weren't you telling me you'd found some evidence?
Like, why aren't you guys bringing all this out on the table already?
Really? What kind of evidence?
It would make things a lot easier.
Actually, you know, now that I'm thinking about it here calmly. It might not be all that relevant.
Honestly, just tell us.
Jeez, does your confidence just get up and walk away? It's fine, man. Just tell us.
It's a life and death situation here. We got, like, no mercy at all.
Really
we gotta go
then.
For it.
Here it is.
Mm? What do you have there?
It happens to be an e-handbook. I found it laying on the ground, so
that,
I scooped it up.
Is that Chihiro's missing handbook? On the ground. Must is mine. It's Chihiro's. Yeah, that one's missing.
We know Chihiro's handbook was missing from the scene of the crime, right?
For a fact.
For a fact indeed. I was totally sure I'd found it.
Then it must hold some
Turn
clue
it on.
About the culprit, right?
Well, that's what I was hoping. But it's busted. It won't even turn on.
It's busted?
I imagine the culprit broke it to get rid of any evidence after the murder.
That's odd. I didn't think the handbooks were quite so fragile.
Yeah, what?
You're right. They're not. They're totally waterproof and shock resistant. It would take an awful lot to break one.
And yet, this one does appear to be broken. As is Leon's, sitting useless in the main hall. For all your confidence, that is a remarkably high failure rate.
Do you think there might be some kind of mystery in there somewhere?
How do they break?
How precisely did the handbooks get
broken? If we can figure that out, we know for sure. Let's put,
I got it!
Weak point? I don't know.
You already told us before that the handbook has one weak point, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah! You remember that? sure, maybe I let that slip, but I never told anyone what the weak point actually was. But if the handbook is supposed to never break, and two of them broke in quick succession, then...
Then we can only assume that someone's figured out its weakness. You know what the weakness is, right, Monokuma? So, what is it?
Huh? You're asking me?
I think it's a necessary piece of information if you want this to be a fair trial.
But if I tell you, and someone else decides to copy it, that would be very not good.
Just tell us already! Why would we want to break our own handbooks?
Oh well, I have a weakness for pushy demands. But you're sure you won't follow their example? Then allow me to make a special announcement.
The handbooks are very useful,
point
so...
Of my cutting-edge e-handbook is... When it's exposed to high temperatures for too long, it will suffer a meltdown and totally break! think?
High temperatures.
I flippin' knew it!
And that's what we needed.
You knew it?
Ace in the hole.
Yeah, cause I found the handbook laying on the floor of the sauna.
And there it is, even more proof.
The temperature in the sauna can reach over 200 degrees. Strange how you don't get burnt, huh?
There it is. We're done.
It's because as your sweat evaporates,
Mondo's done.
It creates a cooling layer of air around your skin.
Mm-hmm.
If the hot air of the sauna were somehow pushed directly onto your skin, you'd definitely get fried. That layer of air would get blown away. That's why you may feel a burning when you move around. So when you're in a sauna, make sure to keep nice and still.
Wow, interesting. I learned one new fact today.
Good job, Ishimaru.
That is a mere trifling speck of knowledge.
You're right, Yamada, yeah.
Anyway, if you
back to the
case.
Victim's
handbook in the sauna, then the killer must have been purposely trying to raise its temperature in order to break it.
Meaning the culprit somehow knew its weakness.
And you know who?
But how'd they find out? Monokuma said he didn't tell anyone, right?
I know exactly how, and I think everyone else knows. Come on, you guys, right? You guys know, right?
What if they found out by accident?
Yes.
What do you mean by accident?
What if the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing its weakness, and it broke? They'd realize it was broken, of course, and it wouldn't be hard to figure out why. And once they had Chihiro's handbook, they knew they had an easy way to dispose of it.
Found it near the sauna, and who are the people that use the sauna, guys? Who use the sauna that we know of?
I won't say it's not possible, but who would have done something like that?
And narrow it down even more, who's the only one wearing their actual clothes to the sauna? With everything inside their clothes still being in there.
I don't know of anyone who took their handbook into the sauna.
Like, yeah, bring their e-handbook into their sauna.
I might know someone who did.
And it all lines up.
Seriously?
I think the one who may have taken their handbook into the sauna was...
Ishimaru knows too. Let's go look at Ishimaru for a bit. Where is he at? Alright, I kinda did like a whole loop. I'm sorry, Ishimaru.
Here's my answer! Mondo, your handbook got broken in the sauna, didn't it?
What?
Mm-hmm. He wore his outside clothes into the sauna, cause he was man enough, and he brought his e-handbook into the sauna as well. I'm sorry, Ishimaru, but he's the one that did it.
Endurance contest in the sauna not too long ago, remember? And
yep.
For the contest, Mondo just so happened to keep his school uniform on. But little did he realize, he'd also left his handbook in one of his uniform pockets. And when it was all over, Mondo discovered that taking your handbook into the sauna could easily destroy it.
I'm sorry, Mondo.
Wait,
you're a real cool guy.
You've got it all wrong. He would never kill. I don't accept this. Show me the proof. The actual solid proof.
I mean, I don't want to believe it either, but something proves it beyond a shadow of doubt. You gotta show us his e-handbook. Yeah, he needs to show us his e-handbook.
Makoto's assertion. If what he says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own handbook.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook is actually broken, then that proves that what Makoto said is right.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
Shit.
See? Look!
Makoto was right. Mondo wouldn't hurt a fly!
I'm sorry, Ishimaru.
Let's test if what he said you broke your own. In other words, if then that proves.
Well, my goddamn handbook.
No, that's wrong.
Now turn on your handbook for all of us. I love this music.
Mondo, the handbook you have right now, Is it really yours?
It's Leon's.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
The broken handbook that was in the main hall.
That one's not Leon's.
Isn't that one actually yours?
What the heck are you talking about?
What I mean is, I think Mondo swapped his handbook out for one that actually works. I think he took Leon's handbook and replaced it with his own. After all, Monokuma said himself that Leon's handbook never should have broken.
That's right! The punishment it suffered wasn't nearly enough to destroy it.
So then, the broken handbook in the main hall is actually Mondo's, which would mean that the handbook Mondo has right now is actually Leon's, yes?
But doesn't that violate the school regulation that says loaning out your handbook?
We've already been through this. It's borrowing it.
Well, here's how I look at it. There is a rule about loaning your handbook to another student.
You're over this already.
But it's kind of a gray area, I admit. But no worries. If anything, it just makes things more interesting. As such, I decree that exchanging handbooks with a corpse is not a violation of the rules.
Well, Mondo, if I'm wrong about this, you're welcome to say so.
I'm
happy to admit I made a mistake.
Yeah.
But...
Son of a bitch!
I'm sorry, Mondo.
What's wrong, bro? Come on! Tell him he's wrong! You are wrong! You have to be wrong! Everything you just said is wrong! You made it all up!
Sorry, Shimaru.
Okay, then why don't we look back on this case one more time, from the beginning?
Here we go, boys and girls.
That way, everything will become clear, and we'll all see if I was right or wrong.
Everyone, climax interference. Here we go. What is this? Oh, that's Togami. We gotta find, yes, this. Night 2. Kichiro goes in the boys' room. Oh, wait. Something everyone has that you need to get in the locker. Okay, it's this. And just to make sure. Locker room, cheer go into. Okay, that's the boys. There it is. Weapon they used, Kirill was. This is the girls' room? Someone switched around the crib in something else. This? Which locker room did the killer move to the girls' room? Killer took something from the other locker room and switched it in the scene of crime. Wait, what? I hope I'm using that right. It looks like he's putting it up, and this one looks like he's taking it off. So I hope I did that right. Killer took something. What? Look, this is just the same picture here. I don't. This? What is that? I don't even know what that is. Nope. I'm just gonna assume it's that. I fuck with Togami here. What was that Byakuya brought to the murder scene? It only could have been the extension cord. Goddamn. What a fucking asshole. That Byakuya arrived on the scene, what did he use this guy? What had happened? Where did the killer go when they were done? The sauna, right? Where's the sauna? time ago I found this honor, what happened to it? It broke.
Here's exactly what happened. First, let's take a look back to before the incident. Last night, Celeste saw Chihiro in the warehouse, correct? At the time, she was apparently stuffing something into a duffel bag. That something was a blue tracksuit. You can confirm this, right, Celeste?
Why do you have to die?
With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out, even though it was officially nighttime.
So nice.
She made her way to the locker
room. So innocent.
Specifically, the boys' locker room.
I like how Makoto's still calling her. Calling her by she. Using she pronoun and her
she. Who was apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room.
Oh, he's probably gonna switch here.
Simple. Because
yeah,
she was really a he, which is why he was able to use his own handbook to gain entrance to the boys' locker room. Once inside, he met with someone there. And the person he met was the one who killed him. It seems like that the killer grabbed the nearby dumbbell, approached the unsuspecting Chihiro.
Why'd Mondo do it? Poor Chihiro.
And attacked him.
What? What? Oh my god. Oh. Oh, okay, it's this one.
Here's exactly what happened.
Thank you for putting it here.
And attacked him. And that's where the bloodstains on the poster and carpeting in the boys' locker room came from.
Kinda ruined the moment, though.
It was likely in the heat of the moment. The body was arranged, but the murder itself felt unplanned.
Yes, right.
Which is why the killer hurried to try and hide the act. First, pulling up the bloodstained carpet. Then, removing the bloody poster.
Honestly, this doesn't make any sense. This part. Why would you do all this? This all, like, extra effort.
And finally carrying the corpse into the girl's locker room.
In fact, it'd probably help him even more if he just left it the way it was.
A girl's handbook was necessary to get
I know why he
didn't.
I know why he didn't, but like.
But this alone doesn't prove that the killer was necessarily a girl.
He's probably gonna explain it after this.
Sayaka and Junko's
maybe not after right after this.
In the main hall. Using one of those, a boy could get into the girl's locker room without much problem.
Probably when we like vote, he's probably gonna
and
tell us why
exactly
he did it.
Exactly how the killer did it. With the carpet and the poster they brought with them, they got to work. They changed the layout of the boys' and girls' locker room in what you might call a crime scene switch.
The old switcheroo, that's for sure.
That could have been the end of things, but no. Byakuya discovered the body and decided to intervene in the situation.
Yep, made it more complicated.
He made it more complicated, that's for sure.
So, after stumbling on the crime scene, he went and grabbed the extension cord from the library, and then he got to work. He used the cord to string up Chihiro's lifeless body. Then, using the victim's own blood, he left a grisly message there at the scene of the crime.
So fucked up, dude. It's so fucked up.
He
Tagani, goddamn.
He wanted to create the illusion that Genocide Jack was responsible for the slaughter. And around the same time that Byakuya was putting together this facade, the killer, having already disposed of Chihiro's bag and other belongings, arrived at the sauna. There, they planned to destroy the last piece of evidence. Chihiro's handbook. And just as the killer expected, the steamy sauna was enough to ruin the electronic gadget. Somehow, the killer knew that the handbook couldn't stand up to the heat of the sauna. And the reason they knew that is because the sauna had already wrecked their own handbook. And that's how it all played out.
And there it is. Here we go.
Isn't that right, Mondo Iwata?
Mondo, why do you have to do it?
Wait. No. This can't be
like, right. I'm sure... I bet his, like, secret wasn't all that bad.
Where's your evidence? Yeah, where's your evidence?
Handbook.
You need evidence. You need proof.
Show us his handbook.
Without any proof, you can't pin any of this on him.
Sorry, Shimaru. I know I'm gonna have to play that rhythm game with you. Mondo is the killer that already revealed itself in the trial. If I can somehow show where Mondo's handbook is right now, to do that, everything will become clear.